Well, I was disappointed to learn that Delta State doesn't have a teleprompter. And sad to know that I couldn't memorize my script. And grateful to Christian for putting me last because I had a hard time getting this under an hour. Yeah, don't need to worry about that at least. So, anyways, if you don't know me, I can tell you this, I hate trash. And I'm sure many of you do as well. I hate to see trash along the roadsides. I hate to see trash along the sidewalks and parking lots on our campus. And I hate to see especially trash in pretty places like on trails and on the banks of streams and lakes and wetlands. So today my story starts with trash at Lakeshore Park in Dalton. And back in the fall of 2000, Lakeshore Park was one of the sites for our annual Comstock River watershed cleanup. And at that time, I admired a small wetland that is just on the edge of the Dalton, now what is called the Dalton State Home Soccer Field. And it's very pretty. It had a beaver lodge in the middle, and it had a beaver dam at one end. And I thought it'd be a great place for some interpretive signs and some environmental education. But as so many things seemed to go, it quickly moved to the back shelf, and I forgot all about it. So 10 years passed before I revisited the park. And when I went to the west side of the wetland, this is what I found. Trash. As you can see, this is not your typical park trash. It's not glass bottles and plastic wrappers and candy wrappers and aluminum cans and occasionally condoms. I've done enough park cleanups. it instead consisted of wooden pallets, piles of dirt and gravel, and piles of grass and big slabs of concrete. And so it appeared that somebody was trying to fill the wetlands. And in addition, the beaver dam had been breached. The beaver lodge was in disarray and obviously abandoned. You can kind of see it back there. The water level was low because of the breached dam. And most of the wetland also was choked with this invasive plant called parrot feather that is native to the Amazon.
What is it?
It's called parrot feather. And so there I was, standing at the edge of the wetland, taking all this in, and I was mad. And so at that point, I formed two goals. One was to see that this illegal filling of the wetland was stopped, and the other was to find whoever did it and have them clean it up. So, although my story starts with trash, and those are my goals, I realized through this process that those goals were actually too small, that there were bigger goals to accomplish there. So although my story starts with trash, it's actually a story about connections and about how collaboration with people with varied interests, but compatible interests, can achieve amazing results, as we have seen at Lakeshore Park, for the benefit of both human visitors and wildlife residents. And in my talk, I'd like to use this story as an example of how we as faculty can unite with our students and with our community to fix problems. So, first thing you have to do is identify a community problem, and there are plenty of them out there. So, of course, you need to choose a problem that you care deeply about and one that you're willing to invest a considerable amount of time and energy into. And then make a list of all the good things that could come from fixing that problem. And in, as they say, think about how can you turn that lemon into lemonade. After a number of phone calls and conversations, it became clear that this wetland mess could be used to compel action and turn this neglected wetland into a park asset. So, partnerships. Now, it's usually hard to fix most problems by yourself. So, you need to recruit others. And you need to recruit others that recognize, as you do, that this is a problem that needs fixing and one that they are willing to invest in. So try to be as inclusive as you can. In some cases, more is more, and I do believe in these collaborative efforts. The more people you bring to the table, the better off you're going to be. And try to seek a really diverse set of stakeholders. The broader the coalition, the firmer the foundation of your efforts. So try to include those also by virtue of their position, that they can make things happen in terms of the politics, in terms of the finances, in terms of the marketing and communications, in terms of the labor that may need to be done. And what I think, personally, is the secret to success, it certainly was in our project here, was to bring in our folks, our college instructors, our students in K-12, students and instructors as well. And if people are going to become committed stakeholders, they usually like to be brought in at the beginning of the project rather than later, so that they can help shape it. And then once your group has been formed, meet face to face and brainstorm. So at our first meeting, we had 17 of us at Brookwood Elementary, and we discussed the potential improvements at Lakeshore Park. And in this discussion, the scope of the project grew far beyond my initial two goals, and of simply stopping at weather dumping and figuring out who did it and have it. Ideas we discussed at that time were stabilizing not just the banks of the weather, but also the lake, which lies to the south of it. Adding a walking trail around the entire park. Interpretive displays, fishing piers, and a boardwalk, a new pavilion. So these are all things that were brought to the table by all these folks that gathered at this initial meeting. And each stakeholder group stood to gain from these improvements, and that's really important. Dalton State and Brookwood, we gained a convenient natural area for education and for research. The city of Dalton and Whitfield County, they were interested because this would increase the use of their park. It was a good fit with the city's goal of creating a greener community. And also, it would lead to the prevention of lake bank erosion, which was encroaching upon the Conway Street. Concerned about that. Conasauga River Alliance, this fit very well with their mission to improve water quality in the watershed. And Dalton Utilities, it fit with their goal of enhancing stormwater management. Planning. Lots of planning. So, during the fall of 2011, our organizing group joined forces with UGA's Archway Partnership, which is a community development program. And the strong support of Whitfield County's Archway Executive was critical to moving our project forward. There were some real movers and shakers in our community that are on that executive board. Once they bought in, I knew that things could move in a good direction, given enough time. So we had two UGA graduate students from the College of Environment and Design. They took our group's ideas and they created these three concepts for the park, and then they hosted a charrette in December of 2011, where community members had the opportunity to come to see these designs and to give their input, which then the students took back with them to create a master plan. So in July 2012, the stakeholder group, we met again to review the ideas formed at the charrette, and then we provided these Archway Partnership interns with the guidance necessary for them to create the final proposed master plan. And, this is Marlon Romo, who was one of our biology majors. So he was in on the plan as well. He's various professors and folks in the room. So this is a view of the master plan. I just point out a few things. So that's the wetland right there. That's the lake right there. This is part of the walking trail that would go around the park. The light green areas represent revegetated areas, trees and shrubs and wetland plants, which would be added to the lake banks and wetland banks. Fishing piers, outdoor classrooms, revitalized, improved stream. So a whole bunch of things included in that master plan. Oh yeah, and one other thing to note, the walkway, Nancy was mentioning this. Brookwood Elementary School lies just to the north of the park, and those teachers and administrators had a great interest in using that park as a natural. Initially, they had to, the school's right here, they had to go up here and then come down and then come over in order to access the wetland. So they wanted to see like a walkway constructed here since they could move right from the parking lot to the park. It was shorter and safer. That was one of their goals. Patience, persistence, and publicity. For 2 years, that was 2013 and 2014, there was no significant progress made in terms of getting needed funds for these improvements. We had great plans, but no money. So it wasn't the lack of trying. We actually submitted what we thought were two winning grant proposals. We were very confident, and both were rejected. And then also during this period, some of the original stakeholders, they took other jobs and they moved on. Thus, patience was needed as well as persistence. Now, while our efforts to make improvements to the wetland were stalled, we did have another group. They have not attended any of our meetings, but they literally jumped in and began working. The return of the beavers. We were glad to see them. So they didn't care about any of the plans that we had previously made. They just knew what to do and to how to do it. So they rebuilt their dam, they rebuilt their lodge, they brought the water level up. That invasive species of plant, the higher water levels, retreated to the edges, and the wetland was looking great before we had done anything and had spent a dollar. So expect those unexpected collaborators. Look for ways to engage our adult and state students and use them as leverage. Since 2011, we've had 18 biology majors who have carried out research projects at Lakeshore with the guidance of four biology professors. They've done such things as analyzing nutrient levels, looking at the role of the wetland of absorbing nutrients from stormwater. We've done surveys of turtles and amphibians and fish and birds and wetland plants and aquatic invertebrates. Nearly all of these students presented the results at regional conferences. As a matter of fact, three of them are in Myrtle Beach today, presenting at the Association of Southeastern Biologists. And throughout these years, long before restoration was a sure thing, we have continually emphasized with confidence that these were before restoration surveys, and that at some point there would be after restoration surveys. And whether they wanted them or not, I gave regular updates to the Parks and Rec Director and the City Council members about the work that our students were doing, trying to keep it on their radar screen. And our adult state marketing and communications team, one of which is sitting back there, they help spread the word for our students to our community. Again, keeping it in people's view. Another way in which we have engaged our students is through biology class field trips. Hundreds, literally hundreds of adult state students have learned about the value of the wetlands, and as they have walked around the park, they have brainstormed about what they thought would improve the park in terms of human visitors and resident wildlife. And so I really do think that through their research and class visits, our students sent a powerful message to our community that these natural areas had great educational value. So this was, I think, one of our strongest modes of leverage. Now, partnering with K-12 teachers and using their students as leverage. If there could be anything more powerful than our students, it would be these students, these short students. One of the most enjoyable aspects of this project has been our partnership with Brookwood Elementary. Their administrators and teachers have fully embraced the idea of using Lakeshore Park as an outdoor classroom and for STEM education. And classes from each grade level visited the wetland area. They do this several times a year, and they participate in a wide array of activities. The fourth grade teachers, those are the ones I've gotten to know best, including one of our own graduates. They were so interested in our annual turtle study that they decided to have their students sample turtles as well. I hesitated, I cautioned them about this idea, but they were gung-ho. So we gave them some training, we loaned them some equipment, and off they went. And I thought given the mud, given the 20-pound, 25-pound snappy turtles that get caught in those traps. But I didn't truly know those teachers very well. And so these teachers and students liked it so much that they purchased all their own equipment, their waders and everything, small waders. And I asked you guys, did your teachers ever wade into a muddy wetland with you to catch turtles? I am totally impressed by these teachers. They have now been doing this for years, and they are inspiration. Our adult state biology students have given numerous presentations to their students at the park, at the elementary school, and on their visits to our campus. We've also joined forces with Brookwood in our annual Privet Smackdown, which we have each spring, an effort to get rid of the invasive plant species which are found in the wetland area. And this was really encouraging, due in part to their engagement with the STEM activities at Lakeshore. Brookwood Elementary became the first school in North Georgia to get state certified as a STEM school. Parents of these Brookwood students, they were huge advocates. They really liked what was happening in terms of STEM education. With their strong support, provided additional leverage for moving the Lakeshore project forward in the community. And some of those parents, they themselves are movers and shakers in the community. And the teachers and the students, they lobbied hard for that walkway that I was mentioning. And by 2015, they had their walkway pay off. So, in 2015, the City of Dalton decided to include the Lakeshore Park project along their list of projects to be potentially funded by a SPLOST. Fortunately, the voters in our community approved the SPLOST, and $2.2 million of those funds have been used to make community improvements to the park. The work was completed in 2017, and now finally, our biology students can carry out their after restoration surveys starting this summer. And finally, of course. Here is the wetland today. There's a new outdoor classroom pavilion at the north end of the boardwalk along the east side. And as the new plants take hold, it's looking pretty good. And I might even say it's on its way to terrific. And I do believe it was the strength and diversity of our partnerships and the clear demonstration of the beneficial outcomes, enhancing the park's recreational values, stormwater control, wildlife habitat, and importantly, education, which led to the City of Dalton's decision to include this Lakeshore project in their SPLOST proposal, which ultimately resulted in the project's success.